morning, all. Ira Epstein with your morning flash update. And this update is for Monday, September 25th, 2023, getting on 8:25 a.m. Central Time. Well, as you can see, a sea of red as we're walking into the markets. Even the metal market's down a little bit. The dollar up. Most currencies getting hit. If I step back here, look at the bonds and notes. They're taking it right on the chin as these markets get hit too. Energy's a little bit of a rally. Yet, if you're a subscriber of mine in the morning, part of my work is saying, no, you shouldn't be rallying right now in the Brent and the crude. You should first drop a little bit because you lost some embedded readings. And yet here we are with the market trying to hold on. So interesting battle there. In the grain markets, the question is how deep the traders want to sell the grains as harvest is underway and then look for the harvest lows. That's going to be something that's important. Now, as we look at the day's action today, and before I come over to our free offers, and that's what these are, let me get you where I want you to be. The Chicago Federal Reserve National Activity Index, the prior was up 0.12. Now we're down 0.16, so you went the other way. We'll see if Dallas follows suit with their monthly regional manufacturing outlook. Today's volume should be on the lighter side around the world. Today is the Jewish holiday of Yom Kippur. It's the holiest day of the year for many in the Jewish religion. Most of the people will be in their synagogues that are conservative and the more orthodox. The screenwriters, they reached a deal overnight. Now, I give them all credit. They were quiet on Wednesday and Thursday. You didn't hear much on Friday. When I wrote the report last night, I was looking all over the news to see if there was a deal or not. There was no word. And then after I published, later at night, it came out a tentative deal has been reached. Now, don't get overly excited. It's still got to pass. Number two, you got to get the actors back in, but this gets things going. And could they be shooting by late October? It's very realistic. And come the beginning of the year, you might actually get your series coming on first run. China property market's in a nosedive. Evergrande, they couldn't even hold a meeting that they wanted to with to issue new debt and so on. Stock down another 22 to 25%. And there's a series of property market companies that are now under even more pressure. It's an implosion. It's slow, it's constant, and it just keeps wiping out value. To make matters worse, this is their golden week coming up, where they take a 7 to 8 days off, starting, I think it's on the Friday or so, that they leave. But it's also one of the best times of the year where people go out and buy new homes. And with all this going on in the property markets, I don't think that's going to give a lot of security. You might be better off buying there a used home, somebody else's, and not deal with the developer because you may never see that property. Government shutdown. Doesn't look to me like McCarthy's going to be able to get anything done. I think you're walking into a government shutdown. We've been here. We've done that before. I'll talk about it during the week. It's not over till it's over, but I don't see how this all comes together in a good way. So when you look at it, these are the things weighing on the market, and it's one of the reasons you have a pretty big sea of red other than the energies today. If you really think about that, the energies and the dollar are up, and most other markets are under some good selling pressure. Grains maybe not so much, but again, harvest pressure there is what you got to look at. And as I said, we have so many different things that you might want to look at. Price counts are super important. Price counts are unique to the Linn Group in that what they do is, think of it this way. You've heard Fibonacci counts and Gann will give you an objective to so on and so forth. It is their own methodology that I have now watched for at least hard over a decade, hard. And I'm very impressed because what it does is it's not an entry signal. It's after a signal and other techniques have been set in. Where might the market go in up to five steps? And it's uncanny how often it gives you right into the ranges of these steps, especially the first step. So if that's something you think you might want to look at, and you're always going, where could this market go? This is pretty cool. And then, of course, all the other services that we offer, they're yours to try out free. All you need to do is go to iraepstein.com, free offers, or move your cursor right up to the top here. Give it a click, sign up that way. Even my services are on there. The Linn Research is there, our charting software, all the goodies you want. I'm Ira. You have a good day. I'll talk to you at the end of it with our market wrap.